visitors have started seeing ghosts. Ghosts? Ryan tells me it's a side effect of this plasmid business. One poor sod's memory is getting passed on to another through genetic sampling. Leaks. Lunatics. Rebellion. And now, bleeding ghosts. Ain't life in Rapture grand?
What are you waiting for, City? It's beautiful!
Help me, man! Can you help me out? Oh, Jesus, God! Somebody help!
Night I got lined up. Everything's ready. Flowers, bottle of wine, even two tickets to the tea garden. Nothing gets the Bettys in the mood like nighttime in Arcadia. Now I just gotta stop by the Thrifty Care to pick up a med hypo, just to be safe. Word is, this ain't Angelina's first visit to the tea garden.
Procedure is a success. The slugs alone could not provide enough Adam for serious work, but combined with the hosts, now we have something. The slug is embedded in the lining of the host's stomach, and after the host feeds, we induce regurgitation. And then we have 20-30 times yield of usable Adam. The problem now is the shortage of hosts. Fontaine says, patience, Tannenbaum. Soon, the first home for little sisters will open, and that problem will be solved.
Help me out! Can you help me, man? Can you help me out? Hey, over here!
Today, Arcadia was closed off to all but paying customers. The man hires me to build a forest at the bottom of the ocean and then turns a walk in the woods into a luxury. Riot asked, should a farmer not be able to sell his food? Is a potter not entitled to a profit from his pots? I started to argue with the man, and then I remembered who signed my checks. Only thing worse than a hypocrite is an unemployed one.
And I could start a business day. Judge.
Somebody. Get out of my territory!
Microscopic. That's what they want you.
Huh.
ask so many questions. Sometimes I like to make up the answers.
You know what they do to vagrants and... How dare you!
Bacteria are microscopic.
Yeah,
that's what they want you to think.
Hurry, Mr. Lee.
Even in the gathering dark, you light a candle. You have saved the little ones when you might have shown your cruelty. I am sending something your way to demonstrate our thanks.
Oh, time for Betty Bye, Mr. B. Time for a nap, sweet angel.
as a fever knock.
Thank you.
Lynch. What is it?
Get out of my fucking arm!
There has been tremendous pressure to regulate this plasmid business. There have been side effects, blindness, insanity, death. But what use is our ideology if it is not tested? The market does not respond like an infant, shrieking at the first sign of displeasure. The market is patient, and we must be too.
Oh.
Gregory, don't come whining to me about market forces, and don't expect me to punish citizens for showing a little initiative. If you don't like what Fontaine is doing, well, I suggest you find a way to offer a better product. On the surface, I once bought a forest. The parasites claimed that the land belonged to God and demanded that I establish a public park there. Why? So the rabble could stand slack-jawed under the canopy and pretend that it was paradise earned. When Congress moved to nationalize my forest, I burnt it to the ground. God did not plant the seeds of this Arcadia. I did.
Wasting my goddamn time.
You might hear things about me, see my name about, think what you will. There was a time I cared about politics, but it's just an excuse men use to kill one another. I'm done with all that. I just want to see the sunlight again.
I shit bigger than you! Blood! I'm losing blood!
Of your condition? Why are you dragging?
Darling, is that you?
from parasite.
Mr. B. I can smell something nasty. Thank you, Mr. B. Hurry! Hurry, Mr. Bubbles!
Arcadia. The man's put something foul into the air.
bottom of the ocean boil. All the oxygen comes from the trees. No trees, no oxygen. Give me a second, Nick. Ryan's woman in Arcadia is an old Betty named Langford. An okay sort, but not above doing a dirty job for a dollar. If she's still kicking around, I'm sure she's gonna want to save her trees. After all, she planted the damn things.
They dress up in leaves and call themselves the Saturnine. Please. They drink human blood and chant, harness the flame, harness the mist, and believe they're touched by the ancient gods. An aging bunch of frat boys tilting back goblets of plasmids and calling it ambrosia.
Thank you.
Also a woman who's not afraid of turning a buck or two. Ryan said if I could boost profits in Arcadia, part of the up would ride on my hip. So I get to thinking, we're paying for oxygen when we got photosynthesizing trees. Hell, we can even sell the extra to the rest of the city and undercut the other guys. Ryan will like that for sure. Fontaine's people have moved into the O2 biz tooth and claw.
Mm-hmm.
to not let anyone out in the event of this kind of emergency. Either we get those trees back, or you're a permanent resident.
Genetic vector that... Oh, look who I'm talking to. Could you find a sample of Rosa Gallagher for me? Look in the grotto. I've got to keep working while there's time.
This was our home! You...
Thank you.
And this is it. Fucking success!
Mary, you just need to...
the poison! Kill the poison!
Thank you.
brought the Rosa Gallagher? What are you waiting for? An engraved invitation? Send it through the pneumo. Yes, this is perfect. Perfect. Come on up to my office. I'm letting you in now. I think I've got just the thing to put the green back in this forest. I've got the security system in this joint hacked, so those turrets won't bite. Come on up to my office. Isn't there anything in this damn place those pagans won't steal? Paper towels, ink pots, witch hazel, chlorophyll solution, even my back issues of National Geographic. They're feathering their disgusting little shrines with it, I suppose. Sick bastards. Says you can't teach an old hound new tricks. This batty plant woman spends 4 years coming up with ways to defoliate trees in the Pacific to scare out the Japs, and now here I am, down at the bottom of the Atlantic, trying to figure out how to do the same thing in reverse. Adam. It's bathtub gin times the atom bomb times Eve with a serpent. Let's go see what it can do.
business deal, you and I, did we not? Money changed hands. Let me read to you from the agreement. Section 3, subsection 4.
Mr. Ryan.
Ryan Industries maintains exclusive rights to the creation, use, and exploitation of the Lazarus Vector. Ownership of civilization.
Wait! No! Please!
Without it, we would be back in the swamp.
Mr. Ryan!
Every time we get a yard ahead, Ryan goes and moves the goal line down to the other side of the field.
On the Japs at Iwo Jima. But I never brought one back from the grave before. I did, Becky. Mama's gonna build her first damn Franken tree. I'm gonna call my little creation the Lazarus Vector. Maybe it'll bring the old gal's career back from the dead as well.
If the only ones around to appreciate it are a bunch of spliced-up morons. I've cracked the Vector, or at least I'm 99% certain I have. I just need a bud of Rosa Gallica to confirm my analysis. Distilled water, a bit of chlorophyll, and enzymes extracted from Apis mellifera. That's right, sweetheart. Honeybee spit.
Thank you.
circus of value. Come back when you get some money, buddy.
Don't fight the inevitable. Run out of oxygen.
Thank you.
circus of
trying to run a business here. You want to spend time with my honeybees? Well, I'm gonna have to start charging you for the pleasure. If I come out one more time and find you lolling out there amongst my hives, I'm grabbing my shotgun. As to your question, yes, my days in beekeeping school are a blur, but I do seem to remember something about that enzyme you keep blabbing on about.